When is the elections?
It's on the 7th of December, hopefully, 2020, which is about, let's say, 9 months, 10 months from now.
So hopefully we're hoping that coronavirus will be off.
I mean, if you read the news, it talks about China, you know, not recording any new cases. And so I feel that maybe within a month or two, you know, the cases will be down and everything will be back to normal.
Obviously, you have like so many plans for Ghanaians, not just people in your constituency, but Ghanaians as a whole. Right. Can you outline some of them for us? I know that, I mean, this is what you're doing.
Yes.
Yeah. We vote for John? Look, what are we getting?
The truth of the matter is that a vote for John Dumelo as an MP for Iowa West is a vote for hope. I'm not just concentrating on the people in Iowa West, but I'm concentrating on some of the people outside the constituency. I mean, there are certain programs I've outlined that I'm going to start in Iowa West. It has to do with school children.
Okay.
And once we are done with Iowa West, we'll implement it in other constituencies across the country. At the end of the day, Iowa West is part of the nation. Mm. And so what I do for Iowa West, if I can do it for other places, I can do that as well, because it wouldn't be fair just to limit everything to Iowa West when maybe the resources are a bit more.
Are you proud of yourself? Let me allow you to brag about, you know, yourself. When you look at you, John, from say 2005 up till now, doing all these things for the country, not just because you wanted votes, unless you're saying something else. Yeah, are you proud of yourself? What do you make of what you've become today?
I mean, if you take a look at the John Dumelo Foundation, for instance, we started doing a lot of work from 2010. I remember one of the first things we did was to go to a school in Wa. To donate exercise books, pens and pencils and erasers.
Yeah.
Apart from that, we've done so many donations across the country. We've done donations in Nigeria, in Zambia, in Kenya, in Guinea. I mean, so many countries across Africa. And so for me, I feel that I've done well, but I feel that I can do more to be able to impact positively the lives of Ghanaians and Africans as a whole. And so I hope and pray that on the 7th of December, the people of Iowa West will be able to give me the mandate to be able to do more for them in the constituency.
Are you getting lots of support, or this is just you doing all these things, getting all these sanitizers? I'm very passionate about that.
You mean where I'm getting the support from?
Yeah, I mean, support. You getting, I mean, monetary and also everybody else involved.
I mean,
I know you get in, you've got industry support, right?
Yeah, I mean, yes, I have friends who are in the industry who are supporting. I also have friends who are supporting physically. I also have a very vibrant constituency executives who are also supporting vibrant physically. I also have people who come and say, look, John, I don't have money, but I can give you a car, or I can give you my energy for the next 1 week so that we go on the campaign trail and talk to people and so on and so forth. And that is what we need. We need, you know, a holistic approach to facing this campaign, so that at the end of the day, I'm accountable to the people who voted for me into power. As for the money aspect, I mean, we are raising it little by little, one city here, two cities here, three cities here, to be able to fund the campaign.
Thank you so much. In all these crises, we need a message from hashtag I did for you, man, for everybody out there who is watching you. Tell us something.
I think in this crisis, we need to be very extra careful when it comes to our hygiene. We need to wash our hands, we need to use sanitizers, and we need to, before you enter your house, you need to wash your hands outside and make sure that you are clean before you enter your homes and your houses. And let's kick this virus out, and let's hope that Ghana becomes COVID-19 free in the next few weeks to come.
Before I let you go, I know that you're doing a number of things. Currently we are at Tesano Police Station. You're doing something very nice. Yeah. I'm sure you don't want us to know about it, but
I mean, I can tell you about it.
Yeah, tell me about it.
What I did today was to distribute Veronica buckets, hand sanitizers, soaps, Dettol, detergents to all the five police stations across the constituency.
Okay.
The truth of the matter is that we need to protect those who protect us. Mm. And so that is the only reason why I'm doing this, because they come in contact with a lot of people, suspects, drivers, everybody. People walk into the police station every day and you never know what one person is carrying. And so if we're able to protect them, they'll be able to protect us and Ghana can move on in the right direction.
For the many people, lastly, that's the last one. For the many people out there, your fans, who has followed you through your acting career, I hope that this is a question from the fans.
Would I stop acting?
Yeah.
I mean,
because we're finding it difficult to.
I mean, it's just like asking probably somebody going into parliament who is a doctor or a lawyer whether they're going to stop practicing. I mean, acting will always be a part of me, and if, of course, I have time. During the time that I'm a member of parliament, yes, maybe a film or two I'll be able to do, but it wouldn't be as often as I used to do it.
All right, thank you so much.
Thank you too.